Hello everyone, myself Vivek and I have Laksh here with me. So we will be having looked at the features of CRM portals available in CRM 2016 update. Everyone is muted right now, so if anyone has any questions, they can type in the question section to the right side of your screen. We will try to answer the questions in the session itself. So this is our agenda for today's webinar. That is, we will be looking at what's new in CRM portals, benefits of using dynamic CRM portals, features of pre-configured portals. So when we get add-on for the CRM portal or maybe the trial for CRM portal, we get 4 pre-configured portals. So we will be looking at the features of these portals. Then we will be having look at the comparison between already existing ADX on-prem portal and CRM portals. Then we will look at the setup and configuration of trial portals, which we have already set up for our trial environment. We will also be sharing the steps with you. And lastly, we will have a help desk demo, that is customer service portal demo. So how we can create a case, resolve a case, and update a case directly from the portal without having the CRM access. So let's have a look at what's new for portal in CRM. So these are the steps that we will be going through. That is integration to dynamic CRM, which is a new thing. Initially, ADX portal was a standalone application, but now it has been integrated in dynamic CRM. Then we will be having a look at the default portal design. That Microsoft have made some changes from ADX designs. So we will be having a look at those. The next thing that we will be looking at is knowledge management. And after that, we will be looking at the features of pre-configured portals, that is self-service portal, community portal, employee self-service, and partner portal. So let's have a look at integration to dynamic CRM. Previously, with ADX portals, we had options to have on-prem version, that is the portal will be hosted on our server, or online version, that is the portal will be hosted on ADX Azure server. But after Microsoft acquired ADX, they have come up with CRM portals as add-on for CRM online. So we don't have option for on-prem CRM portals. However, we can continue using ADX on-prem portals. Over here, we don't need separate CRM user licenses for CRM portals. By default, it uses CRM system user. The next thing that we are looking at is the default portal design. If anyone has used the ADX portals before, they will observe CRM portals have come up with major change in portal UI. They call it this theme as electric blue. They have used Bootstrap, which makes portal look nice and is responsive. All the Bootstrap responsive design elements can still be customized with your own corporate brand or theme. The next thing that we will be looking at is knowledge management. CRM 2016 includes a new integrated service hub with a new robust knowledge management platform. CRM portals has updated the knowledge base functionality in the portals to now use this new knowledge management platform for display of articles, including all enhanced capabilities for approvals, versioning, and rich text formatting with images and videos of the knowledge base articles. CRM knowledge base articles will not be used over here. Also, there are certain pre-configured portals, as I said, so we will be discussing features of them as we proceed. Over here, one more reminder, if anyone has any questions, they can type in the questions in the question sections to the right side of your window. So over here, we are looking at language availability for portal add-on. So for Spring 2016 Wave, the portal add-on will have language parity with CRM Online, with exception of 4 languages, that is Chinese, Hebrew, Japanese, and Korean, Arabic. So over here, this will be released in coming updates. Next we will be looking at is benefits of using dynamic CRM portals. So implementing a portal can help you give the right people access to the right data without giving them full access to your CRM system. With a portal, you can increase revenue opportunities, increase productivity by providing timely access to the information, extend your CRM system outside your organization, and enable input from external parties. allow users to access information themselves when they need it, improve customer and or partner communication and satisfaction, and build stronger business relationships. So as we discussed, there are four pre-configured portals, that is customer self-service portal, community portal, employee self-service portal, and partner portal. So we will be looking at features of all these portals. So we will start with the customer service portal. So customer service portal is basically kind of help desk for the users. So customer can come over here, they can open the case, they can update the case, and they can also resolve the cases from the web portal itself. They don't need to call up the customer service guy or mail him. Hey, they can directly come over here and create the cases. They can also access the knowledge management over here, that is knowledge base articles. So what happens is, when a customer comes to the portal and he has a query on portals, so what will happen is, instead of creating a new ticket, he will first search it in the knowledge base articles. So if the knowledge base article is resolving his issue, then he don't need to create a case, which is, I guess, very quick option for the user. So we can also have discussion forums on the portal, on customer service portals. We can manage and track support entitlement and consumption. We can also have polls to gather ratings and comments. It also allows customer to access knowledge base articles, as we discussed. And the default authentication on this portal is based on the CRM contact. So whenever a new user wants to access the customer service web portal, his contact record will be created in CRM, and all the authentication and authorization of the knowledge base articles and cases will be done based on that contact record. Next we will be looking at is the community portal. This is basically a superset of customer portal. It has all the features of customer portal. Other than that, it also has some additional features like ideas, blogs. However, there are certain features that are available in on-prem ADX portal and not in CRM portals. Those are event and conference management and issues. The next one we are looking at is the employee self-service portal. So employee self-service portal is set up by default to use your Office 365 Active Directory authentication instead of the standard local CRM contact authentication for portal sign-in. So what happens over here is that any of your Office 365 user can have easy access to your help desk, knowledge articles and forums. So over here, the authentication will be based on Office 365 Active Directory. There won't be any contact record, there won't be authentication based on the contact. However, contact record will be created for web roles and all of the portals. Next we are looking at is a partner portal. Strong partners enhanced with one-to-many self-service options help your partner succeed. This can be delivered with a partner portal that distributes leads, track deals and opportunities, and provides account management capabilities. The partner portal has undergone an overhaul to make use of all out-of-the-box features like entity list, entity forms and entity permissions. One of the new piece of functionality that CRM portals has come up with and is being utilized in partner portal is a new subgrid, that is timeline. So what basically timeline is, in a partner portal, various partners can share a particular opportunity. So when a one partner is updating or something on the opportunity, other partner gets to know from the timeline grid that partner A has made changes in this opportunity. So this is kind of timeline feature. So we can have a look at that timeline feature in the next image. So here we can see how timeline feature looks into action. So over here, a single opportunity has been updated by other partners. So we can have all the activities tracked down on the entity form itself. Now we will have a look at the differences between on-prem ADX portals and CRM portals. So Laksh will be leading the session here now.
Thanks Vivek. Now let us look at the difference between CRM portal and the on-prem ADX portal version 7.x. The first and the most important difference here is code access. In on-prem ADX portal, we have a complete .NET code access, but in CRM portal, we don't have any code access, but still we can do the customization using Liquid template, jQuery, JavaScript and the HTML. The next difference here is profile management, custom authentication. In ADX portal, we can have the custom authentication implemented in our portal, but whereas in CRM portal, we don't have that facility. In ADX on-prem portal, it comes with lots of many pre-configured portals like customer portal, partner portal, e-commerce, government portal, community portal, company portal. But CRM portal only comes with four portals, pre-configured portals. It's customer portal, partner portal, employee self-service portal, and the community portal. The next difference is the deployment choice. In ADX on-prem, we have a deployment choice, like we can host it in our own server environment, in our own IaaS, Azure, wherever we want, we can host it. But CRM portal is not the same. It's a SaaS-based system. So the next point is Parachar integration. Parachar integration is currently not supported in the CRM portal, but it is there in the on-prem ADX portal. The next, the compatibility with the Microsoft Dynamics CRM is ADX on-prem portal 7.x will support 2013, 2015, 2016 and 2016 online Spring Wave. But CRM portal only support 2016 online Spring Wave. Now let us look at how we can set up and configure our trial portal. First of all, to get trial account access, we have to click, go to this particular URL, crmagenttrial.dynamics.com, and we have to fill in the detail over there and we have to submit it to Microsoft. Microsoft R&D team will evaluate your request, and if they approve it, they will send with the activation link. Once you get that activation link, you can just click on that link and you can associate this trial portal with your existing CRM 2016 environment, or you can create a new trial environment for that. The steps are as follows. You have to log in into the Office 365 portal, and in the admin section, you have to go to Admin Center CRM as shown in the image. The next, in CRM Online Administration Center, click on the application on the top, and then you can see the portal add-on in your Manage Application section. Then click on that, and the next you can see the Manage button in front of that. So click on that Manage button. It will take you to the portal detail page where you will have to fill in all the required detail, like what will be your trial portal URL, what kind of pre-configured portal you want out of that four. It's mandatory select any one of that. Then you can fill in your other details and you just have to submit. So it will take around 30 minutes to set up everything for you. In 30 minutes time, your portal will be up and running. So this is how you can set up and configure the trial portal for yourself. Now let us have a look on the demo of help desk. Since we have already set up a customer self-service portal in our trial environment, so I already logged in as Joy Camp. He's a contact in my CRM record. So I have some query, so I will go to my support to raise a ticket, support ticket. So as you can see, the view is almost similar to the CRM entity view. So here you can see the drop-down where it will show my open cases, my close cases, all cases, as we can have option in our CRM entity. And in the below grid, we can have the basic information. We can do the customization depending on the customer requirement. Now suppose I have some query, so I can just go and type in the search area, like I will type portal. So it will search for me in my all the KB articles, forum, matching with that keyword. If it matches, it will show me the articles. Then I can click on that. I can go, use that help. I can resolve my query. If not possible, if not my query is not resolved, then I can just have option to open a new case. So it will take me to the create case page. So here in the title, it will also have the same feature like search. When I type the keyword, it will search in the KB articles and blogs and forums everywhere. So if I get the solution here, I can just click on my, I found my answer, and that's it. If I don't have any found the answer, so I can proceed with, like, it's my customer is already populated Renaissance service. My name is already Joeycam. I can select the case type, subject. I can type in the description what kind of issue I am facing. Then I can, if I have any screenshot or anything to attach, so I can click on the browse and attach the file. Then I can click on the submit button. It will submit the case into the CRM. Now that case has been submitted into the CRM. Now let's go to the CRM and we can see the case. Just let me refresh the grid. So here you can see the portal issue has already came up in the CRM. So I can open it, I can view it, I can assign it to the my support guy. They can update the case status from here. And so whatever the detail I have filled in, it's all the details has been already came in the CRM. Suppose that particular problem has been solved. Now the customer will go log into the his portal and he will click on the case number. So it will open up in the edit mode for him. So there he can add a comment if he has any additional comment, like he want some additional information on the same issue. And he has some file, then he can attach it. So as an he will submit it. So the same comment can be seen in the case in the CRM. You can just refresh the page.
This seems to be a nice feature, Laksh.
So here you can see the comment.
So Laksh, I do have a question over here. So as we see that when you added a new comment, so it didn't came into the notes section. Instead, it came into my activities.
Yeah, this is the new feature which has came in the CRM portal. They have entity in portal comments where the, all the comments are earlier it has to go in the notes section, but now in the new CRM portal it will go into the comment entity, portal comment entity. So as you can see, it came up in the activity. You can go and add. If you have any update, you can just have to go here, add the comment. you can save this record, but still I am not marked as a completed. So if I go to the portal, I was not able, if I just refresh this page, still I was not able to see that comment. I can go here and click on this mark as complete. So when I click on this as mark as complete, so this will be available in the portal for the customer to view. So as you can see that we'll provide an update, it's already here. So after that, if the customer want to close the case, he can click on the close, he can click on yes. This particular case has been closed for that particular. Suppose if you want to reopen, you have the same issue again. So you can click on this reopen, click on yes, it will reopen the case for you. Similarly, you can, once you get the update, you can close it or you can cancel the case. This is how the support portal works from the through the CRM portals. Now let us have a demo of how we can have the customization through the admin credentials in the portal itself without touching the code. Now as you can see, I logged in as a system administrator over here. So in the my right hand corner, you can see a small panel with preview on children, edit, delete and new options. Here children's are like all the pages of this particular home page will be visible in the children section. If I want to edit any of this template, then I can click on this edit. It will open up an edit content editor for me. I can modify, I can, like you can see, it open up the content editor for me. I can modify and save it. It will take the effect immediately. I can delete it, but make sure that you're not deleting the home page. If you delete the home page, your site is gone. So next option is the new. Here I can add a new child page, new child file or child forum or shortcut. So let me show you a child page. So in the child page, I can just have to specify the name of the child page, title, and whatever the content, it's rich text box content editor. I can insert image, flash file, tables, anything I can insert over here. If I have any HTML code, I can just go to the code section. I can write the HTML codes. Then I can select the who is the my parent for this particular child. And then I can have the page templates selected, web forms. If I have any web forms, I can select web forms, either entity forms or entity list. Any of these three options we can select. And when we click on save, it will save as a child page for that particular home page. Now, next, suppose if I want to edit this particular section, so I can click on this, edit. Here I can type anything, like suppose if I want to use the liquid template here, so it will fetch my full name and display it on the screen. This is basically a liquid template script through which we can, it's just with the minimum coding, we can have that in our page. I can save it. So as you can see, the Renaissance system administrator. If I go to the the contact entity, so there also you can see his name has already came up. Just add modified in the admin section, the same has been reflected in the customer portal also. Similarly, I can have edit option for the my primary navigation. Here I can go, if I don't want to show the knowledge base article, I can just delete it, or if I want to add any of the section, I just have to click on this. I can give the name, I can select the page, which page I want to display. If I have any image or anything, then I can just add in the image and just save it. This is how we can modify the portal UI without having access to the code. Okay, that's it from our side. If anyone has any question, can mail us at lsshetty@cloudfront.com or vshah@cloudfront.com. Thank you everyone for attending the session.